So after revision of the previous topics, now let us start the harmful fungi. Fungi are useful as well as harmful. Yes. My bedroom. Okay. Actually, yes, there's also the classes are going on. I'm not alone in the room. So the classes are also going on, but only the stuff I can go. So my voice is not that clear. My voice is not. Okay. Today you manage like this, next time I will see, okay? So the harmful fungi. Harmful fungi. What do you understand with this term, harmful fungi? Why the hands are raised? The harmful those are not means those are harmful means those. Causes diseases or spoil the items, different things or substances, they are the considered the harmful fungi. Yes. Fungi like some of the fungi are causing the food spoilage. They spoil the food. Means they grow on the vegetable, bread or the food and they start spoiling the food product. Where they grow, you know that they started releasing the digestive enzymes and as a result the food started decaying or decomposing. So means these some of the fungi they grow on the fruits, vegetable and bread and they started spoiling, means they started releasing the chemicals, they are toxic in nature and if that food is consumed by someone then it causes poisoning, it causes means harm to the person or the organism. So that is why the some fungi are harmful because they spoil the food. Why? Because where they grow on some food and they release some chemical, those are toxins are toxin in nature. Spoilage of non-food substances. Now fungi cause spoilage and ultimately destruction of non-food substances also. Means like food spoilage, they cause the food poisoning. And some of the non-food substances are also are spoiled by some fungi. Like textile, wool, paper, furniture and even shoes. So they grow on damp clothes and leather and damaged clothes and shoes. So means some of the fungi, they are not only damage the food items as well as they attack on some of the fungi, they attack on non-living substances also or the non-food items also. Like they can be any like paper, furniture, wool, textile, shoes, even the lenses. Means microscopic lens or the spectacle lens, they are also damaged by the some fungi. Then they can cause diseases as well. Some of the fungi they cause disease.
cause disease like some of the fungi they cause disease in the plant, like mold, mildew, smut and rust, they cause disease in plant, and they just destroy even the whole field. If this infection is started in the crop, then that this fungi is spoil the whole crop even. So they can cause disease in human being as well, like athlete foot, oral thrush and ringworm. So these type of diseases can be occur in the human being also due to some fungi. And polyporous is a type of fungi that can cause the decay of a standing tree. Means a healthy tree, living healthy tree can be, you know, decay by the polyporous tree. Usually what happens? The decaying starts when the organic, means the plant and animal die. But when this polyporous start living that on tree, so what happened? It start decaying even the living tree only, and they just what you can say, and they just cause damage to the plant tree, and that the standing tree, that the living tree, that the healthy tree started damaging and start decaying. So some of the fungi, even they decay the standing tree. Some of the fungi, they cause disease in plant. As a result, the whole crops are destroyed. Some of the fungi, they cause diseases in human being as well. And some of the fungi are poisonous. Means mistakenly, some toadstool is eaten by some people. So toadstool is a poisonous fungi. People used to eat mushroom. Sometime by mistake, they just taken that toadstool. So that is harmful and they can cause death to the person. So these are the some harms of the fungi. So we discussed the useful fungi also, means they are useful in many ways. We discussed how the useful, the very big thing that they are the what you can say, the source of recycling of nutrient, and that's very important. Means we discussed in the previous class uses of fungi. And without that, the life cannot be possible on the earth if the nutrient recycle will not go. If it is stopped, so at one time the life will be stopped, because plant need organic matter, the simpler organic matter to grow, and without plant, life cannot exist on earth. And along with that, we discussed other uses also in the previous class, like some of the fungi are edible, some are used in medicinal and the commercial products, some are used as in baking and alcoholic products. So fungi is useful as well as harmful both. So now the chapter is done. Is there any confusion regarding it? So you can just ask me. Yes. Okay. No. Means yes, of course. Means like we'll start the planting in this only. Sorry, means this topic is done. By mistake, I told the chapter done. Means like now we'll start the kingdom planting. Okay. So the kingdom planting. What do you understand with this? Plant you term. Now the back volume is also not there. My voice not. Why two hands are raised? Yes, why these hands are raised? What do you want to say, Haya? What do you want to say? You raised your hand. Yes? Yes.
Yes.
Muhammad Abdullah, you raise hand. What happened? Muhammad Abdullah, you raise hand. What happened? Yes. So the king, now the kingdom planting. Kingdom planting consists of multicellular organism. Like we take or classify the organism into five categories. What's that? Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista, Kingdom Fungi, Kingdom Plantae, and Kingdom Animalia. Now Kingdom Plantae we start. So Kingdom Plantae consists of multicellular organism that are autotrophic in nature. We know that the plants are, all the green plants are autotrophic in nature. Then mode of nutrition is autotrophic. So they can make their own food by using the different raw material of the provided by the environment and in presence of chlorophyll and the sunlight. So they don't depend on other organisms, they just make their own food by using the different sources provided by the nature. So the nature directly provides the things and they make their food. That's why they are autotroph. They are not needing any other organism to make their food. Like we depend on the plant. And if the plant or any or somehow we depend on animal also to get the food. So plant, we depend on plant and animal, then only we are able to make our food. Otherwise, we also cook our food in the kitchen, but we are not considered autotroph because we depend on the plant and animal. We cannot make our food its own only. Means like plants are not needing animals or the human being. They just utilize the raw material provided by the nature, their self only, and they provide the food to us. We depend on them. So we depend, that's why we are not autotroph. We are heterotroph because we utilize the plant and animal for making our food. So that's why we are heterotroph. So most of the plant, they grow in the soil only, as we know that they just absorb the nutrient and the water from the soil. And both the things are very important for the survival because without water, the chemical reaction cannot be possible. So the water and the minerals are very important for the survival of the plant, so they grow in the soil. And all the plant kingdom is categorized into two category: non-flowering and the flowering plant. Yes. Some vegetables come from flower. No, some vegetables, not some fruits. What's the difference between vegetable and flower? What is the difference between vegetable and fruit? One at a time. One at a time. I'm always saying this only. One at a time. It's not audible at all when everybody started speaking at the same time.
Yes, now Mohammad Umar, you were telling you there, and whoever want to say after Mohammad Umar, raise your hand. I will give you a chance, but don't speak like this. Yes. Other than the flood, very good, mashallah. So the edible part which we get from the flower, that is actually the fruit, and the part which is which we get other than the flower means it can be from a stem, it can be from root, it can be from leaf, means other than the flower, then it is called vegetable. Okay, so the plant kingdom is categorized into two category, that non-flowering and the flowering plants. Now let's start with the non-flowering plant. Non-flowering plants, non-flowering means they do not bear the flower or seed. Non-flowering plant means they do not bear flower or seed, and that's why they are known as non-flowering plant. And they reproduce mostly by means of spores. And plant of this spores we discussed in the rhizopus as well. Yes, what do you understand with the term spore? Raise your hand. Yes, Zubia. What do you understand with the term spore? Okay, one at a time. Everyone will speak at the same time. Afsha, tell me quickly. You don't know. Okay, then you raise hand. Okay. Abdullah, yes. Yes, Muhammad Abdullah, tell. Yes? Yeah, okay. The source of reproduction, you can say. Source of reproduction, so spores. They just act like a seed. Like when we sow the seed in the soil, we get the new plant. In the same way, when the spores get the favorable condition, they change into the young one. So they are the source of reproduction. Okay, so non-flowering plant, they do not produce seed, but they produce spores. This is the difference. Note down. Just you should have notebook and the pen in your hand. When whatever the point I am telling, you should note down. So the difference is that non-flowering plant are producing spores, and they are also agent or the source of reproduction, because when these spores exposed to the environment and they get all the favorable conditions, they convert into young one. This non-flowering category means the non-flowering. This plant are categorized into flowering and non-flowering. So non-flowering category is further categorized into subdivisions. That is like algae, mosses, liverwort, and fern. So non-flowering plant, they are further categorized on the basis of complexity of the plant body. Means how complex the plant body is. On the basis of the plant body structure, they are categorized again into the different category like algae, mosses, and liverwort and fern. So let's start with the algae. So algae are actually they are the most simple aquatic plants, and their body is not differentiated. Means it's just a mass. It's not differentiated into root, stem, or leaf. It's just a mass of the cells. So it's the simplest plant, you can say. And its body is not differentiated into plant, what you can say, the root, stem, and the leaf. And that's why the special name is given to it, that is called thallus. Here you see this thallus like structure. This is not algae, this is a liverwort and mosses they are. But you know, means here if you see, algae is more simpler than this. I'll show you, wait a minute, another picture, that is of Spirogyra. Spirogyra is also algae. Here it is, Spirogyra. This is algae, and Spirogyra name given because of the spiral chloroplast present in it. See, this is the spiral chloroplast. Here, this is the green color chloroplast. Because of that, the name Spirogyra is given to it. So, yes. What? Algae are actually the plant. They are the simple plant. They are just primitive plant, you can say. They having the chloroplast. They are autotrophic, but they are primitive. They are not having the proper body structure. They are not, their body is not differentiated into root, like the plant is having the proper root, proper stem, and the different parts, leaf and all. It's not having, it's just a mass of cell, and it's having chloroplast in it. Like here I am showing you the structure of Spirogyra. In this, just a filament is there, filament, the cells are, you know, end to end attached to get the shape of filament. And or you can say thread like a structure, and then the chloroplast is there. This is the spiral chloroplast. This is the spiral chloroplast, and in that means the chloroplast arranged in a spiral manner. You can see here they are spirally, they are arranged like this. I'm not understanding your question. Means it's not like they grow, they are not parasite or saprophyte, they are autotroph. Wherever there means like nutrients, the favorable conditions are there, moisture, nutrient and all are there, they can grow. That's another thing, they are the symbiotic association also, like lichen. Lichen grow with the fungi, means fungi and the algae, they grow together. The combination of these two organisms, that is called lichen. They both help each other. They mutually benefited each other. Means the algae, fungi, algae and fungi, they live together. And how they help each other? Algae is actually the autotrophic organism, and it can make its own food because the chloroplast present in it. So it makes food, but how it makes food? For that, fungi provide the raw material, means fungi can absorb nutrient and water. So fungi absorb nutrient and water and provide to the algae, and algae make its food. So the algae provide the food to the fungi, and fungi provide raw material to the algae. So both are helping each other. This type of relationship is known as symbiotic relationship. That's another thing. If you talk about only for algae, algae is a primitive plant. They are having chloroplast, and because of that they are autotrophic. They are the simplest autotrophic plants, you can say. Yes, what are you saying? Means like when the body, plant body is not differentiated into what you can say root, stem and leaf, then the plant body, this is known as thallus, 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 because the structure, it is just like a mass of cells. As I have shown you the mosses and the this mosses structure, sorry, liverwort structure. So in liverwort also, that is the structure that called thallus only. Why there also that the body is not categorized into different type of structure. Like if you just see the plant structure, the root are having the different shape, the hair like or the thread like structures, and then the stem, that's another structure, and leaves are of the another type of structure. So that's not categorized in the thallus. Thallus is just a mass of cell. It's not showing the proper root, proper shoot system. So that type of plant body is known as thallus. So algae is also the plant body is thallus, and in mosses also the plant body is thallus. Means specifically if you talk about mosses, means like bryophytes. Bryophytes are consist of liverwort and mosses. So liverwort are actually the body of the liverwort is considered as thallus. Even if you see the moss, then it's little differentiation starts. Means it started growing the leaf like structure, as you can see on the page number 50. Here the leaf like structure as well as the stem like structure or the capsule is there. Yes. Okay, I will explain you. See here. See here. It's a thallus. It's a thallus. Means it just grow as a mass. It's not like if proper plant. It's proper plant always just having you can say the root like this, and then stem, and then here the flower, and then leaf. These type of structure, that is actually what you can say the plant having the different the proper structure or the well developed structure. But in thallus, the body is not categorized into different part, and it's just a mass of cells.